know I was preaching. He was a preacher of righteousness, telling people that there would be a flood and that they would need to repent and turn and get into the ark because the flood would have come and destroyed the world. And you will ever hear in your life, because it is the truth about God. Because God wanted to prove to you how much He loved you, so He died on that cross and shed His blood, so you wouldn't have to run from Him anymore, but you could come. You could come at the feet of the cross and pour out your heart to your Creator, pour out your heart to your Savior. Give thanks to the one who died for you on that cross. My friends, because there will come a day that each and every soul will need to give an account of what they have done in this life. You will need to give an account before your Creator, because one day the day of truth will come, and that day of truth is when you will die and you will see your Maker, and you will see the light at the end of the tunnel. But what you have done with Jesus Christ will determine where your soul will spend eternity, because you see, your soul is eternal. And your life on this earth will determine where you will spend eternity. My friends, think about eternity. Think about that day when you will die. Do you fear death? If you know Jesus and you have Him and believe in Him, you will be saved. And you wouldn't have to fear death. But you need to respect the holy. You need to respect what you don't understand. You need to respect what you don't know. My friends, you need to respect your Creator. You need to respect the living God, because you will have to give an account to Him for every idle word that came out of your mouth. And you will have to give an account for every thought and every deeds that you have done on this earth. My friend, this is the purpose of this life. It is to determine where you will spend eternity. So where do you want to spend eternity? You see, the Creator has given each and every one of us free will. And you have the free will to choose to either come to God humbly and believe. And if you believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, and if you confess with your mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord, you will be saved. And your soul will be saved. And you will be saved freely, because the price was paid by the blood of Jesus. Jesus paid the price for your salvation on that cross. My friends, do you understand the love that God has for you? Do you understand the grace that God has for you? Because it is not by your works that you will be saved and justified on the day of judgment. Because none of us will be saved or justified by our works. Because we all have sinned. And one sin separates you from your Creator God. And Jesus came to pay for the sins, so your sins can be washed away, so you can have a clean slate, and God can look to you like if you would have never sinned. My friend, there is no sin that you have committed that God cannot forgive you, but you need to confess it and forsake it and repent from your sins. And that is why we're here, because the kingdom of God is at hand, my friends. And that is why we call you to repentance. Repentance means to turn away from your wicked life and to return to the living God, to live a life of holiness, to live a life of righteousness. And this is what we are. When Noah was preaching, he was a preacher of righteousness, telling people that there would be a flood and that they would need to repent and turn and get into the ark, because the flood would have come and destroyed the world. And still today, you know, back in Noah's day, they mocked Noah because they said, what are you talking about? A flood will flood the whole earth. But if you look at all of geology and all of civilization, every civilization has a story of a worldwide flood. But you see, soon enough, God will destroy this earth again. But if you want to be saved, you need to repent from sin. You need to repent from your wickedness. You need to repent from your unbelief. You need to repent from your rebellion. And God will forgive you if you humble yourself. if you repent from your rebellions and your unbelief. My friends, just like in the days of Noah, when people were mocking Noah for preaching about righteousness and about a worldwide flood, well, still we're here today saying that one day this world will be destroyed by fire, but your soul can be saved. Because the good news is that God will create new heavens and a new earth wherein dwelleth righteousness. And in this new heaven and this new earth, there will be no more sickness. There will be no more pain. There will be no more death. There will be no more injustice. And this is the world that God wants you to inherit. But in order to inherit this paradise that God is about to create soon enough, you need to repent. You need to recognize your sinful state before your Creator, that you have broken the commandments of God. And if you do humbly, God will forgive you. God will welcome you into His family, and He will put His Holy Spirit into you. Because you see, God does not want to live in buildings only. He wants to live in the temples that were not made with hands of men. He wants to live in your body, which is the temple in which He wants to live. And if you welcome Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior, then the Spirit of God will be living inside of you, and you can have an intimate relationship with the living God. Because you see, God is not mocked, and you can mock God completely with your immorality and your sexual perversions, and you need to repent of your sexual perversion and immorality, my friends. And if you do that, you can have an intimate relationship with the living God of purity, of holiness, of purity. My friends, God is a God of purity, and He's calling you to repent unto purity. He's calling you to repent unto holiness and righteousness. My friends, I've been living in both. I have lived in debauchery and immorality and perversion. And I've lived, and now, by the grace of God, in holiness and righteousness. And let me tell you that a life of righteousness and holiness is more fulfilling than any lifestyle of sin. My friends, I'm calling you to repentance today, because the Lord Jesus Christ is alive today. He rose from the grave and He conquered death. And He is still alive today to save you and to bless you. My friends, I just want you to be blessed by the living God and experience the living God, that He is alive today, yesterday, today, and forevermore. He does not change. He is the same today, forevermore. And He wants you to know Him. He wants you to repent, to call upon the name of Jesus. Because you see, whoever will call upon the name of Jesus shall be saved. And you will experience the living God. You will experience the Holy Spirit in you. You can experience a change of heart, a change of your life, a change of lifestyle. I know, Jake, God bless you. Oh, my friends, I'm here to let you know that the time is short, that the kingdom of God is at hand. My friends, the living God, seek the truth while it may be found. Seek the truth with all of your heart, and respect the holy. Respect what you don't understand. And you see, the mystery of godliness is that God was manifested in the flesh and walked among us 2,022 years ago. And He came to save us from ourselves. He came to save us from our sins. He came to save us from our rebellions. My friends, tonight, if you call upon the name of Jesus Christ, you can experience a new life. You can be born again of the living God, born again of the Spirit of God, and you can have the truth living inside of you, and you'll have that testimony living inside of you. My friends, call upon Jesus. Seek Him while He may be found. Because you see, there is a time where there will be a famine of the Word of God. And that whenever you would want to seek after God, you won't even be able to. Because you see, the devil is the Lord of this earth. And that is why he is the father of lies. And he created all these lies to lose your soul. Because he knows that his time is short. And he wants to take you with him in the lake of fire. He wants your soul to burn in the lake of fire, in the fires of hell. But Jesus came to save you from the lies of the devil. He came to save you from an eternity of regret and torment in the flames. My friends, give your soul to Jesus today, because God loves you so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever would believe in him would not perish but have everlasting life. For you see, my friends, you have value in the life in the eyes of God. You see, God values your life. And maybe your parents have abandoned you. Maybe your friends have abandoned you. Maybe your girlfriend has abandoned you, or your boyfriend. But let me tell you the truth, that God will never abandon you if you humbly surrender your life to him and follow him and believe in him. He will never forsake you nor abandon you. He will be with you forever until the end if you trust in him, if you believe with all of your heart. Because those who come to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of those that diligently seek him. So my friends, I ask you to seek him, to come and seek him with all of your heart. Place your faith. You see, Jesus said, if you had faith just like a mustard seed, as small as a mustard seed, you can speak to this mountain and tell it to move, and it shall obey you. So come with the little faith that you have, and God will show you how big he is and how good he is. You don't need to have a much faith, but just a little faith. And God will show himself to you. He will reveal himself to you. And if you want to know his secrets, if you want to know the milk of his word, then open the pages of the Bible. My friend, this Bible is the word of the living God. And it speaks the truth about this world. And it prophesies so many things that have happened. If you would only take the time to study about the prophecies that were accomplished in this book, and you will see this book has spoken about the days that we are living in. This book has spoken about a time in the last days, right before that Jesus Christ would come back, that there would be a world government, that there would be a push for a world government that will control the world in a totalitarian way, where no man would be able to buy or sell without having a mark on their right hand or on their foreheads. And my friends, if you look and study around, you can see that this technology exists today. That technology that can control your life, and that will bring tyranny upon the earth. And my friends, this is what the Bible calls the mark of the beast. And you see, the beast hates your soul. He wants to torment you. He wants to dominate you. He wants to remove your rights and your freedom that God has given you. And my friends, you need to resist the beast and the antichrist system and the tyranny that the governments and the world government is trying to put. My friends, I'm telling you, the Bible prophesied about these days. And he said that these would be the times where the end would come, when Jesus would return to set up upon the earth his kingdom, where he will rule and reign in righteousness by the man that he has risen from the grave. And my friends, Jesus Christ is the King of all kings and the Lord of all lords that will rule and reign upon the earth on that day when he returns. And on that day when Christ will reign and rule, there will be no more sickness, because his throne will be founded upon justice and righteousness and equity. And I know that isn't that what every single man desires? They want justice, they want equity, they want righteousness. And this is what the human spirit desires. But this is the promise of the living God for those who will repent from their sins and trust in the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who died on that cross and rose again 3 days later. This is not religion, my friend. It's about the person, the living God who raised from the dead and who conquered death and who is alive forevermore and who heals today, who does miracles still today. And he is the real.